The last game did this too, but only at the end. In this game, we're constantly re-examining how we feel about Ellie. We like her from the previous game, but now she's on a quest for revenge that is way over the top.
I can like people who are on a quest for revenge. Her being on a quest for revenge is, I'm totally fine with that.
He described the quest for revenge as way over the top. I'd be like, please be specific what you mean by that.
The bride, Kill Bill, were we on board with her? Yes, all the way through.
But, God damn it. So, she wants to kill Abby, that is the revenge. In order to get to Abby, she has to get through all these other people who are trying to kill her. She kills them. Oh, now you've gone far over the line. I'd be like, what do you mean? What are you talking about? Yeah, what are you referring to specifically? Yeah, please tell me.
Along the line.
And if it's simply a number of people killed, I'd be like, so, when in war, once you've passed a certain line, it's like, no, you need to go home. This is going a bit, this is a bit far.
Yeah, there's the quota. Oh, you got 10 kills? Good job.
Your kill streak allows you to stop.
To go home.
Yeah, your kill streak is you get to go fucking home.
The implication is that the revenge story was okay up until enough people died. And I'd be like, so what's the number?
Manny's head.
I mean, but that was a good thing.
It was a very good thing.
We understand her anger, but she's avenging someone who single-handedly did more damage to this world than anyone possibly.
Possibly, yeah.
That's a big possibly, too.
Yeah.
A faction that knocks him out, chucks him outside, is going to get the power to inoculate who they want, and they're going to become altruistic and distribute it evenly amongst everyone.
Don't forget that they welched on the deal with him, too. He went through fucking fire and water. He went through everything you could imagine to get her here.
Mm-hmm. No, and I think Southpaw said this. Do you think they wouldn't leverage the vaccine to gain more power for their faction?
All the issues we're bringing up are all contingent on the idea that they could save the world with this thing, which is not true. That is not true. The world is fucked whether or not you get a cure.
Yeah, they could only inoculate living people at the moment. That is it.
How many people are dying to spores right now?
Between the factions? Well, were all of the issues with the faction infighting wars, did they have anything to do with the infection?
No. It was just getting resources.
So those things are still going to happen.
Yeah, not to mention the only thing this helps with is people walking into spores or surviving bites. That's the only thing this helps with. And those two things are not killing that many people these days. It is, but if you want to look at the kill count tied to faction warfare or to the infected ripping you to shreds, the numbers are much higher.
Yeah, they'd be a lot lower if you sent out people to deal with the infected and gave them stuff like armor.
This is the thing, the game doesn't earn this. And you can lay this at the feet of The Last of Us 1 or 2, but it's 2 that decided to condemn Joel as having destroyed the world, in a sense. It's like, well, that's not true.
Joel, man, bad.
They didn't think this through because they want to be childish and say, it's a cure-all, just chop off your head. Like, okay.
Possibly could.
Think about what he did.
I did. It was pretty good.
How many people are dead because of him? How many people are dead because of you guys?
Those people are dead because they got bit by infected. Let's not play around with it. He's not the reason why they're dead.
Well, unless she's referring to all the people in the building that were shooting at Joel, in which case I feel like they signed their death warrants at that point.
Yeah, I feel like if you shoot somebody, you gotta kind of expect, at least to a degree, maybe they're gonna shoot back
with a flamethrower.
Yeah.
Literally every death that happens after the first game is Joel's fault.
And no.
Wow. Are you fucking right? There's your take, ladies.
Jeez.
Okay, this
How do you reach that conclusion?
They didn't switch the brain on, did they? They didn't switch it on.
How could you say that shit?
Amazing. We have completely removed agency from every other fucking character now.
Yeah.
That's insane.
Like,
that's...
No, guys. Joel told the zombies to attack.
I'm sorry, what does Just Right think would have happened had Joel let Ellie die? What exactly does he think would have happened?
No, everyone will get along, and the zombies won't bite people.
We're going to have a new
The
new
WLF still exists. The scars still exist. Like, what the fuck?
Like, I'm happy to leverage, like, the best possible, like, the most fucking idealistic outcome for that of, okay, the cure would be instrumental in rebuilding the world. I could agree to that, even though there's a lot of, you know, landmines along the road there. But why do people feel the need to frame what happened at the end of the game like this?
Because it would make killing Joel justified in their version of the game. I think that's where people are.
Even if it's a long shot, the ambiguity is there.
But what about, like,
is that long shot worth Ellie's life? So on and so forth.
But you've got one person. How much vaccine are you going to be able to create? And then you've got to try and distribute that vaccine world fucking wide.
Yeah, that's not going to happen.
The vaccine might only take care of those fucking 10 Firefly people that they can get from Ellie. That's a fucking...
Dude, the amount of death. Anytime anyone goes on any adventure, we have to deal with hundreds of fucking clickers trying to rip our faces off. But no, it'll be easy to get this cure to everybody in the world. Nobody thought about this. They don't care.
Even though we've got two fucking vials of it, and that's all that we could.
I'm gonna go use the loo. Process that.
Sorry, we will appreciate this poster of Fat Geralt. What a fucking legend! Look at him. I like how this image implies he needs a sword. No, sir.
No way. Now he's putting his sword away so he can get his fists out.
Oh yeah, I'll take that interpretation.
Yeah. That's how I see Fat Geralt. Whoa, Fat Geralt, bang a bang. Whoa.
Waller, why do you think he said that? Why do you think Just Right said that shit?
Probably to I think he's preloading how much Joel's a bad man to help deal with the game's narrative.
That is a poor take. That is a real.
And like, if he says it as if it's an understood fact. So, for example, it's like when people go, Poe's journey in TLJ was really interesting, considering the huge mistake he made in the opening, and then they move on to the next point, like, wait, let's go back to that. What do you mean by that? And then they're like, I don't want to talk about that.
I can have my reservations about what Joel did without having to go for, yep, the cure would be instant, guaranteed, turn on the switch and everything's back to normal. They'd be able to get it everywhere, they'd be able to make as much as they want.
Well, this is, like, so this is the fundamental
to
problem, right?
To, like, question his actions.
We've had to deal with this before when people use the canon of the sequel trilogy to defend the sequel trilogy, but some people are like, Joel's motivation wasn't that in the second game, though. He makes that clear, and it's like, that's the second game. You can absolutely decide, post, that that everything went through Joel's head, and that all at once he decided this is the thing he's going to do. And you can have him admit that really, none of that even matters, because he's not going to let his daughter die again. That's the ultimate, right? But the idea that the game says Joel didn't think about any of these motivations, it's like, okay, I disagree. Like, the idea that they had a gun into his head isn't coming into his thought process, like, nah, fuck off.
You find these things in the game, and you're playing as Joel.
Yeah, Joel is not taking it easy, these decisions.
Ergo, Joel knows these things.
Nah, he just killed everyone.
It's Joel's fault, the world's burning.
I think someone asked me a legitimate question in chat, I just can't help but see Keanu Bundy. What about the Firefly's attack on the military? But yes, the Fireflies are not saints, the second game seems to believe they are.
Yeah, and like the Abby call, it seems so hopeful. Like, oh, the Fireflies can rebuild the future. That was the framing, which really annoyed me.
What the fuck? What's with all the emotes in this post? Five guys sitting or talking about someone else's video because these five wrote a lot of movies and games. Holy fuck. Like,
I haven't wrote very much.
No, I haven't written a full movie or game.
What movie and game did he write?
I do it as a hobby. I don't hate anything.
And we're better at it, so what now?
Well, the only response is like, yeah, but what about my arguments, though?
Yeah.
Also, Just Right hasn't, so...
I don't know if he has, actually. Maybe.
Oh, surely not, because of how terrible he is.
Oh, no.
Oh,
the Rags, we're talking about a project that was horribly written by someone who wrote it.
So, oh, like... yeah, but we didn't write something else, so, ha.
Oh.
So it Adam. Showed us.
More interesting arguments, please.
I was going to say, our numbers are a little higher than usual, I think. We've probably got a few Randys in here who've not seen our stuff before, so we're probably pretty pissed. And that's okay. You're welcome to like this game. It is okay.
Yeah, you can like it. It's just a shitty game.
Oh!
No, you can't say that!
I mean,
how dare you?
Your catharsis is your own. I don't have any investment in it.
Yeah, this is the opposite of catharsis. It's his attack.
I just like the whole.
That's what I say.
Oh, be right back.
Weekend Warrior sits on a chair, it breaks, and he's like, "What the fuck, this stupid chair?" Then I go, "What are, the, are you a carpenter? Shut the fuck up."
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, like a restaurant, you can say that the food is shitty. Like, are you a fucking cook? Like,
did you make a chair? What? Did you make a fucking chair? What? No, it's not on one though.
No, it doesn't work. Can you tell me the mechanics of making a fucking chair work? It's like,
there's a counter. We've had writers come on this show who do agree with our points of view on a lot of stuff. So there you go. Argument from authority. We win.
God, fucking got him.
Gotta get Drinker on. Drinker, you wrote something. That means your value is higher than ours. Do it.
Do it.
Oh, I see Harry. Is that Harry?
Hmm?
Oh yeah, I see his emotes. Like, good job.
Fucking wrecking me with emotes. I can't handle it.
Oh, got him. So wait, can we go back to the other idiot that's talking?
We can. We're gonna listen to what he said again. We're gonna do it.
Anyone
here comes.
Possibly could.
Think about what he did.
I did. It's
How
fine.
Many people are dead because of him.
It's justified.
Literally,
doesn't
every
matter.
Death
Not everyone that fucking died is Joel's fault.
And
okay, bitch.
The fact that he said literally as well. It's like, no, yeah. That means there's no room. No room for discussion.
More damage.
No, the zombie group. That bit right. The person is because of Joel. Fuck off.
Than anyone possibly could.
Think about what he did.
The turf warfare between the Seraphites and dead? The wolves in the second game is Joel's fault.
This is what surely he's gonna justify it, right? Because what the fuck?
You don't have to frame it like this to call Joel a shitty person.
No, yeah, you can make it very. This is what's so beautiful about it, writing-wise. Yeah. You can talk about how it's fully informed by his fucking loss of his child. It's like, come on.
Because of him.
Literally every death that happens after the first game is Joel's fault.
Literally
and every
everyone.
Single person. All
those people you saw strung up and had their stomachs cut open, Joel's fault.
Yep.
Someone dies in Joel. Space. And it's like, Joel.
Damn it, Joel!
Someone tripped over their shoelaces.
Joel!
There's two globes fighting each other on Spacatus 9 and they die. Joel!
Spacatus 9.
It's like a huge boxing match.
I got syphilis from fucking that whore in that alley.
Joel!
Fucking Joel! Wilford Brimley dies. No, Joel! He stops getting low-cost, affordable diabetes medicine delivered straight to my door! Damn you, Joel!
Damn you, Joel!
No!
Wait. Does that mean all life is thanks to Joel, too?
Nope, just the death.
Just the deaths.
Just the death.
Dude, Joel is at the core of everything. Anything that happens, it's Joel.
Goddamn Joel.
Joel, dude.
If we make him a good character.
Also, we've played this part like 7 times, but we can't play it without getting fucking pissed. Let's see if we can do it this time, okay?
Much to this world than anyone possibly could.
Think about what he did. How many people are dead because of him?
Literally every death that happens after the first game is Joel's fault. And every single person in the world has caused
you
to
shot?
See him punished.
Yeah, Joel's fault.
Ellie just shot there. That's Joel's fault.
Yeah.
I got it.
Obviously.
He says something after it. I'm gonna find out what it is. One of these playthroughs, it's gonna happen.
No, those houses on fire. Joel
is fire. He's the god of fire.
Just like Force Yoda summoned lightning and burned down the sacred Jedi tree stump. So too did Joel come back and lightninged all of those huts.
Do you think there's people who are a fan of Just Right and listened to that and thought, yeah, that's true.
Yeah, Joel is responsible for all of this.
Let's pretend for a second the cure was as simple as they had a machine that takes a brain and generates infinite cure that spreads through the air all over Earth instantly, right? And they let that happen. It does it. And then everyone is like, harmony time. Huh. And they start dancing with flowers and bunnies everywhere. And it's just the best thing.
Wouldn't
ever.
Prevent any of the conflicts that happen.
I want to know, if the Fireflies have all of the research that goes involved, you know, that's involved in extracting this potential cure from Ellie, how is the surgeon the only person that can perform it? surely if the research is there, other surgeons would be able to perform it.
Why, if he was the only one who could, as soon as they found Ellie, he was like, shit, I better make plans that in case anything should happen to me, we can have someone else perform this.
Yeah.
And how come afterwards no one else got that research and did something with it?
Remember how long they've known that Ellie exists? Been a fucking while.
Yeah, half a year, or more than a year, we'd say.
I don't even know if it might be... When was she infected? Because Marlene knew about it really early on, so...
Like early in the game. Springtime, early year, whenever that was.
She's about 13 when she got bit.
Yeah, so it's been more than long enough. Literally, I'm only allowing him like a week of time before I would be like, okay, now I'm getting annoyed that you haven't prepared for this.
We could.
Think about what he did.
Yes, it's
how
still
many
bad.
People are dead because...
And if she was so precious, why the fuck didn't they go to Ellie and not vice versa?
And also, of course, we'll get to there eventually. I don't know, maybe we're sparing ourselves from a worse fate. But how couldn't you just frame it and say everything that happens in this game, it's Abby's fault?
It's the meme. It's like, it's Abby's parents. No, it's Joel's parents. No, it's their parents. No, it's their parents. It's just like the cause and effect chain. We're going a little bit far with the cause and effect chain, I would say. Adam and Eve's fault.
Abby had no choice but to trek from Washington to Wyoming or wherever the fuck and do all that. All right, no choice.
Here we go. Let's do it. We can do it this time, I swear.
Of him.
Literally every death that happens after the first game is Joel's fault, and every single person in the world has cause to see him punished.
All right, I'm going to take a bathroom break real quick.
Every person in the world. Every person in the world has reason to see him. Really? Really, though?
Yeah, I don't agree.
See why they might be pissed, but...
Every person in the world has reason to see him punished. I'd really want to explore that with him, because I'd be like, are you suggesting that everything would be better had he allowed what happened to Ellie to happen? Because I don't know that we know that. Imagine the faction
wars. Did Abby ever learn the context of why Joel did everything? You'd think that's a big fucking part of it, you know?
Well,
surely somebody...
The element we keep kind of, you know, jumping on is like, so the Fireflies become the dominant faction because they own the cure. But you know what happens when the WLF find out that in the hospital where the Fireflies are holed up, they have a cure and they're hoarding it? They're going to attack them.
Yeah. No, everyone's going to get along because there's a cure.
Like, what a fucking naive perspective that the whole world should be angry at him because everybody would have been better off had he let what had happened happen.
There's a simple answer to that. It's, we are the world, we are the children, we are the one.
Joel did 9/11. He was fucking Joel.
It kind of fucked up that he did that.
Joelicons.
Yeah. Joelicons.
And yeah, and if he's appealing to the idea that Joel did an immoral act, therefore people have a reason to kill him, I'd be like, yeah, so that means people have a reason to kill basically fucking everybody in this world. Like, everybody's been killing the shit out of people. That's
you
kind of part of the point of the game, isn't
sacrifice
it?
Sacrifice my daughter? Well, then, yeah.
Well, Ellie has generated about 1,000 Abbeys in the course of the campaign. All the daughters of all the men she's killed, or, well, the women too, any of them, any family member. It doesn't have to be the
men and the children too.
And the babies. And so, yeah, it's all so hypocritical. It's all so tiresome.